Thank you for tuning into this broadcast today. This is Raymond Mayfield. I've been doing videos since 2014. I've got several hundred of them on YouTube, and I've been real interested. I started off, didn't know much what I was doing, but over the years I've learned a little bit more as I go along, and I still want to improve every day to make you a blessing, to be a blessing to you on the things of God. I thank you so much for tuning into this broadcast. I always enjoy hearing your comments and your likes. Thank you so much for all of you that follow me, and I appreciate it. I want to talk to you too much about a lot of things that has to do with the day. You know, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It says that in chapter 13 in verse number 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You know, a lot of things have changed today in our environment. I mean, I can't believe of all the changes that has taken place in the world. I can remember back when I was a youngster, I used to drive a 1949 Studebaker. When I came to Southwestern Assemblies of God, I had a 1952 Black Mercury. And I remember that my dad gave $250 for it and said I could pay it out on a monthly basis. And a car for just 8 years old, actually, when I went to school in 1960. Now cars have changed now so much to where technology is so great today. You never know the advancements of airplanes and communications, the social media. Everything has changed so much. But I want to talk to you about something that's never changed. The Word of God will never change. It's always the same. It's the same message. Every day that you listen to it, it's the same message. The plan of salvation is still the same. It's never going to change. It never is outdated. It's the inspired Word of God. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, and today, and forever. You know, we read about in the Old Testament a lot of things that God had done for us, and listened to all the words of all the prophets and all the things that went on there. And many of them have not even come to pass yet. They're futuristic still, but we know Jesus is coming soon, and we know that His Word is the same. Oh, I'm so glad He is the same God that we served many years ago. I'll be 78 years old in a few days, and I'm really glad that God has given me and put me in this ministry. I'm not pastoring a church nowadays. I retired from active pastorate about a year and a half ago, and I'm enjoying my time, and this is my ministry that I do now. I do live videos. Of course, I would probably be preaching in some churches, but the pandemic has made it to where it's almost impossible to travel places and go because of that. But folks, I want to tell you what, that doesn't make any difference. God's Word is still the same. He can save you today if you'll only ask Him into your heart. Today, if you'll harden not your heart, He will open your heart. Pray to Him. You may say, well, I don't know the right words to say to God. Just talk to God like you'd talk to someone else. Talk to God and open up your heart. Ask Him to forgive your sins and wash in His precious blood. You know, Jesus gave everything on the cross of Calvary for us. Everything that we have today is blessed of God. And I want to thank God today because He has blessed us in so many ways. You know, heaven is real. We're getting forward to go to heaven one of these days. I've been working some in funeral homes lately, and I've had the privilege of even ministering in some funerals lately. And it's really an interesting thing to be able to communicate with people and to deal with people. I thank God every day because we're getting ready for that great day. And that great day is when Jesus comes back to this earth again. But I think that I'm going to live till the day Jesus comes. And if that's not possible, I know that my body is going to be resurrected and I'm going to be in the presence of God. If you're saved, you'll make it to heaven. If you don't get saved, you're not. It's a gift of God. The gift of God is here before you. Don't pass up the greatest opportunity of your lifetime. We hear all the time over the internet and things about this great opportunity and that great opportunity. I don't know why people don't understand the greatest opportunity is a plan of salvation. We're going to live in a place called heaven where the sun never has to shine again, because in the city where the Lamb is the light, it's going to be a glorious city where the people of God are going to live. No more drugs, no more narcotics or things of that nature. No ungodliness in that great city. It's going to be a people that are washed in the blood of the Lamb. Don't you appreciate the plan of salvation today? Jesus wants to minister to you in your life today. Will you open up your heart and let Him come in? And thank you for listening to the broadcast today. I'll be coming to you again real soon, and may you have a great day today.